Hello everyone, welcome to this video series on experience of a master student in 20 university in electrical engineering in Netherlands. So I have with me Nishant. He shared his experience of applying for the university in the previous video. You can check it in the info card, or maybe it will be flashing on the screen. And in this video, we'll be focusing exactly what was his experience right from last year, September, till now, and what is happening with the current situation and all types of experience like internship, study load, life, cost of living, everything. So let's start with the first question. So it's a big one, so maybe I will ask it in parts. Like, what is your experience of doing masters in 20 electrical engineering till now, considering the maybe first we go for the four things like study load, grading, ECTS and internships.
Okay, so you'll have to remind me of this if I forget.
Yeah, maybe we'll go one by one, like maybe the study load and teaching, and then we'll go to the next one. I'll remind you.
Okay. So the study load, I think it's a bit higher than your bachelor's in India. And that is because there's a lot of focus on assignments and not just like the final grade. I mean, final exam, that is how my experience was in India. And yeah, that requires you to be on schedule with everything. So, and especially with the Corona thing, now that some exams have been canceled and have been replaced with assignments. So it's like having an assignment for every subject every week. And yeah, that's a bit more than what you had in India.
Okay, and how is the teaching experience, like the normal classroom teaching? Is it what is the difference that you feel as compared to India?
Okay, so the teaching experience for me has been varied. There's some good professors, some not so good professors, but in general, I think they try to connect everything with their research. So either the assignment or the examples they show in class would be connected to some like practical application or some company that they worked with or a publication of theirs. So that's one major difference. And even with the assignments, it's like you have to make a calculation and like arrive to some similar results as them or use their models.
Okay. And how is the grading and ECTS?
Okay. So ECTS
again,
wise,
the European credit system. I just tell them if they don't know.
Yeah. So my master study is consists of like 120 ECTS over 2 years. So the first is like 60 EC in courses. And the second year is 20 EC in internship and 40 EC for your thesis. And so far, I've been taking 15 EC per quarter because we have like a quarter system and that adds up to 60 EC. I find that the 15 EC is a very like manageable and good amount. And doing more than 15 can be rather challenging. And I've also found that if you take like two 2.5 EC courses in addition to two 5 EC courses, that sometimes has a bit more workload than your 15 EC. So that's something to look into.
And how is the grading? Like the grading scale, and how conservative or strict or like?
Okay. So here the grading, a 6 is required to pass. It's a scale of 0 to 10. A 6 is a pass. I think the average grade would be a 7. If you've done like a very good job, you'll get a 9, but I don't think I've ever heard of like people, I mean, I have heard of like two people getting a 10 in like one assignment, but like getting a 10 or like full marks is pretty unheard of. Usually you will get like a 7 or an 8 if you've done a good job. And very rarely you will get like a 5 or a 4.
Okay. And 6 is the passing, right?
Yes, 6 is where you pass.
So how is the group work? Like I remember like during apart from the assignments, people also work on group projects sometimes as part of the coursework. So how is your experience and how much group work you really get in this coursework?
So two of my courses have been problem-based learning courses. So there's no instruction. You just are given a problem, and in a team of like 3 to 5 people, you try to figure out like a solution for that problem. And at the end of the week or something, you have to make a presentation, and that's what your grades are based on. So in that way, I've had like one group that was like PBL plus a project. And in another subject, I also had like you were given like design choices to make according to a group. And I think that's a good way to learn, especially, and it's also a good way to get stuff done, especially if you can divide tasks between each other. So you divide the whole assignment into 4 parts, and then you come together and explain it to each other. And that's been my two group work experiences. For most other courses, it's like just one assignment that's with one other partner, and I don't know if you can actually like call it group work. Yeah, that's a separate thing. Yeah.
And you mentioned that the thesis is 40 ECTS, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. So do you have any idea about like, because basically you can do like a university thesis or industrial thesis. So do you have in mind from now, like what you are going to do in the second year, or you have some time to decide it later? Like
right now, I don't have an idea, but let's see if like, because I'll also be having an internship before the thesis. So it depends on how well it goes with the company and how, if they want to sponsor, I mean, if they have a thesis idea in mind, then I can maybe do it at the company. But usually for electrical engineering, I've spoken, and my program mentor says that they prefer training in-house because then they can like ensure the quality of how the thesis is.
So you mean like in the university, right?
Yes, in the university, yes. They prefer that you do your thesis in the university. So the whole goal of the program is to have an academic experience and also a work environment experience.
Okay. So how approachable are the professors, and what is your experience of any mentorship? Like maybe, I don't know if you are till now associated with any PhD or postdoc. Normally it comes when you start the thesis, but what's your overall experience till now? Like how approachable are professors when you have face-to-face contact or appointment or something? And what is the quality of mentorship that you experienced?
Okay, so if you have any like questions in class, of course you can ask them. You can also email to them and they get back pretty fast. And if it's like a bigger question that requires like more in-person discussion, you can always like schedule an appointment. I had an experience where I could not schedule an appointment because the professor was so busy, but we just knocked on their door and just like found her and discussed it pretty soon. So that was nice. In general, yeah, the professors are pretty like, you can ask them anything and they will take the time to explain it to you properly. And especially now, I think email is more used.
Okay.
Yeah, for mentorship, yeah. I don't really have a PhD student assigned to me yet, but I did speak to a PhD student before in University of Twente in the group that I want to do my thesis in, and she suggested some courses for me to take that she thought were helpful for her. But apart from that, I haven't really had any experience with PhD students.
Okay. I remember like 2 years back in TU Delft, we had something called student counselors. So they necessarily don't guide you in the coursework, but they guide you like an overall mental situation and physical and other kind of things. So do you have something like that, like a provision for a student counselor if someone wants to go for any psychological
Yeah, for the, yes, for the you have student psychologists here who will like give you assignments to help with your like mental stress or like whatever you're dealing with, but I personally don't really have any experience with them, so I can't really say much.
Okay. And final part of the study experience, like do you have any study groups or association through which you can like maybe travel, have a cultural trip or a research-based trip, or maybe social events like Indian Student Association or something like that?
Mm-hmm. So there's of course an Indian Student Association in University of Twente, and they organize like the big events like Holi, Diwali, and all the like holidays that are celebrated in India. They also like try to do a small party and a talent show and all that. Apart from that, you also have like study associations related to your study. So the for example, for electrical engineering, you have a study association, and they have some benefits, like you get a separate study space, you have like access to some older question papers. You also get like, they also have like cultural things like Cantus. And as you said, they also organize some trips. That is like before the Corona thing, there was like a group planned to go to Japan to have like a foreign experience in the electrical engineering field. But again, I'm not associated with the study association, so I can't go much further. Yeah.
Okay. So what is the total cost of studying for tuition fees without funding, and then you can like throw some light on the funding opportunities which people can have, like for example with part-time jobs, teaching assistants or student assistants or any other option that you know of?
So the fee for non-EU nationals is about 16,000 euros, and the cost of living that you have to like show in your bank accounts is like 11,000 euros per year. Both these amounts are per year. And for funding it, I think finding part-time work in like shops and all is difficult, so I think it's better to be a TA. And I know some friends from like other departments who are TAs. You can also do an internship, and that can support you a little bit and also give you the experience at the same time. But again, you have to manage your time really well then, because trying to do an internship and study something, or trying to do a TA-ship and study something, is a difficult task.
And do you have any idea, like approximately how much is it per hour you can get if you are a TA? Like maybe roughly how much you can earn in a month or something like that?
I think around 14 euros per hour as a TA, and I don't know, that depends on how much how many hours you work. And as an intern, you get around like 400 euros per month. So that's the going rate mostly.
Okay, so what are the proportion, what is the proportion of Indian students, internationals, and how is the overall atmosphere?
I think 50% of the students are I think international, at least in my department, and out of that, maybe out of a total 25% would be Indians, 20% might be Chinese, and then you have like 5% who are like from other parts of Europe or like South America, also North America. Yeah, and 50% are Dutch.
Okay, and how's the overall atmosphere? I think everything is in English, right? Like,
yes.
So,
definitely.
How's the social atmosphere like?
So the social atmosphere, I think you need to seek out people if you want to make friends. It's not like you'll automatically become friends with them. And for that, there's also some opportunities, like you have the, when you come in, you have like an introduction week called the kick-in week. And there you meet people from your same department, so like EMCS, But they will be from like different countries. Some will be Dutch, some will be from other, from India, some will be from other parts of the world. There's also a program called the Buddy program here, where they pair like two international students with a person who's from the Netherlands or has been living there for like 6 months. So they can show you around, they can help you answer like the common questions and like help guide you with the everyday things. And also have like fun activities, like they have bowling, you have scavenger hunts, ice skating, and just learning about the Dutch culture. So they also celebrate the Dutch holidays, like Sinterklaas and all that. So I think that's a good place to make friends. Other than that, I think everyone speaks English, and it's just like depends on how much effort you put into others. That's how much you get. Yeah.
Okay. So this may be a difficult question, because I ask this question to everyone I interview, like, what is one thing that you like and one thing that you dislike the most about the master's program in electrical engineering in 20 University in Netherlands?
So I'll have to think about that. I think if you're talking about the program specifically, I think I like that I have a lot of flexibility in the courses that I can take. So like my specialization is on the border of things. So I can take like courses from biology, chemistry, I can do physics courses. So it's nice that my supervisor is also like pretty supportive of the courses I want to take. And the one thing I dislike, I think the workload is a bit high, but that's okay. That's not that big a deal.
Okay. Yeah. So what are the living and housing options? Like, do you, for example, in TUDELF, we had like a housing organization which arranged house for 1 or 2 years, and then you search once you know everything. And so what is the situation in 20? And what are the estimated monthly expenses that you pay for rent in the housing every month?
Okay. So first we will talk about like the housing options that the university provides. So Enschede is a university city, and there's like University of Twente and also Saxion High School, and they together run a housing platform called Roomspot or Roomspot. And
is it Saxion Applied Sciences?
Yeah, Applied Sciences. Yes.
Okay.
So they have like Applied Sciences colleges like all over the Netherlands, and also one branch here. And together they have like a housing website that gives you access to some campus housing and some housing in the city that is provided by like different housing corporations. Other than that, you can rent through like Facebook, or you can look at what do you call it, the specific like real estate dealers, and you have to like look around for housing on all three platforms, in my opinion. For the costs, I think an unfurnished place would be like somewhere between 320 to 370 euros. And it also depends on like the number of housemates you have. So the more housemates you have, the cheaper it is, and also the room size, the smaller the room, the cheaper it is. I think the extremes that I've seen is like around 250 for a very small room where you can just barely fit a bed. That's possible. And on the higher side, you can have like around 500 to 700 for like even studios, where everything is like furnished and like you have services included. So
you are saying something.
I was saying that so the house that I currently live in is like 350, and it was unfurnished. And before this, I was living on the ITC International Hotel, which is owned by the university, and it had like a cost of like 470 euros per month. But there you had like changing of the bed sheets, vacuuming, and kitchen being cleaned. Like the kitchen stuff was cleaned every weekday, and vacuuming and like cleaning of the toilets, and changing of the bed linen and towels every week. So you get what you pay for, like, yeah.
Okay. And can you like give very short, briefly, like how much you spend apart from the house, how much you spend every month? What are your other expenses in brief, like a range or something? What a student can expect like in 20?
Okay. So I think I'll talk about the fixed expenses, which is like your rent, which for me is 350. You have your phone bill, for me that's like €7 a month. For groceries, it's around like 120, 130. Apart from that, you need to have some one-time expenses, like if you're going to rent an unfurnished place, you'll have to buy all the furniture, and that depends on like if you get secondhand and or do you want like first-hand stuff. You also have to have like $60 to $80 for a cycle, which is essential in the Netherlands. Apart from that, like I spend like maybe €20 or €30 for like day travel every few months, and just like buying normal stuff. So in total, it comes around to like a bit more than €500 per month.
You mean also including the food, right?
Including the food and rent, yes. Those are the main two expenses.
Okay. So let's go to the next question. What are the job opportunities after master's in electrical engineering in 20 Netherlands? Mm-hmm. Like whatever you know till now, maybe you can just shed some light on that.
Yeah. So for electrical engineering, I think it's a pretty good option to study here, because you have a couple of big companies that are also based in Enschede and Hengelo, which is the surrounding city. So you have companies like Demcon, you have also a lot of startup opportunities. So yeah, if you also want to do an internship, I think startups are also a good idea, so you can get to learn a lot. But I think, at least from my experience for applying for internships, it has been pretty positive. Like I've applied to two places and both of them accepted me. But again, because of the corona thing, you also have like a hiring freeze at some places. So everything is a bit weird right now. But in general, I think it's a good place to study, because it has like a lot of like startups and established companies that you can apply to.
Okay. So how is the current situation because of COVID-19 affecting you and your studies? Like, do you have any effect or you don't see any effect? What is your experience?
Okay, so I really like the routine of like just getting ready in the morning and having a nice 10-20 minute bike ride to the uni. And I kind of miss the separation of like work and home. Like I'm sitting right here in my bedroom and like working till I fall asleep. and that is at a very low efficiency, so that has been affecting me a bit. But other than that, I think the major change between post-COVID and pre-COVID study is that the focus on assignments has been increased. So that in a way is nice, because again, if you're like on your toes all the time, then it's like good for your learning, and also like you don't have that much pressure at the end of the quarter. So yeah, that's been my experience in a nutshell.
And did you already like give any exams in this situation, like the online exam or oral exam or something like that?
So yeah, the university had shut down before the last quarter ended, and that was before most of the exams. So everyone was just like trying to figure out how to do the exams in an online way. One of them was an open book exam. So that was like just filling up a Word document form. We also had like a online presentation for a final in one of the courses. And in one of the courses, it was a closed book exam, but there's not really a way to verify that. And it was just like you write it on paper and you scan and send. But this was like really when the whole situation like started to become worse and the teachers had to adapt very fast. I've also heard like other students have like a special program, like a lockdown browser, which has you record all your surroundings and has you record all the apps that are working on your laptop. But yeah, it's a different experience for every course.
And does the university make any announcement about like, I mean, I was going through the VSNU guidelines and they say like till 15th of June, they're going with the online thing. And after that they will announce again and they will resume in slowly some face to face depending on the necessity. So in your case, is it like till the 1st of September, everything is online or you will have the resumption of small lab or class work or something after 15th of June?
So for the official policy is like as much as you can, you study at home, and if you have to, you begin working in like labs at a limited capacity. Officially, it's like the coursework will remain at home until the 1st of September. But like since today, like 1st of June, the library has been opened. Earlier, there was a smaller study space for people who could not study at home. And now even the main library has been opened. But I think most of the education will be taking place at home until September. For PhD students who have like some experiments to run in the labs are open, but at a limited capacity.
Okay. So finally, ending the interview, do you want to give any advice or tips to people who want to come to Netherlands in the future, like the incoming aspirants?
Mm-hmm. I would just like say that learn the language, be open to making friends, and be open to like ask questions, and that's going to be like good for also your social life, and asking questions and like being more confident and being more comfortable with like presentations is going to help you with your study here. Also, I think a lot of Indian universities don't focus that much on the practical tools like MATLAB. So it would be nice if you can do a refresher on MATLAB before you come here. That's a pretty commonly used tool in most of the courses here. And if you can, you should learn LaTeX or LaTeX so that your assignments can be prettier. And it also helps with like your thesis, and I think most of the courses have some component of doing either a review paper and like
maybe
assignments.
Like,
so these are like these skills
you might also you might also write papers if your work is interesting, and people also sometimes publish at the end of their masters, so you never know.
So having some writing experience is nice, and knowing these tools can like make your life easier.
Yeah, that's a very good point. Thank you very much for giving your time for this interview, and I hope that each of you got some information. So please share this video if you want to help each other out, and don't forget to smash the like button if you like this video. And subscribe to the channel if you have not subscribed yet, so that you get all these interview videos and other information about studying in Netherlands and Europe. And see you in the upcoming other interview vlogs. Till then, bye.